Welcome to the Buzz NYC Live. On today's show, we are talking about all the hotness that has been buzzing the streets this past week. Who just broke the record of the most likes on Instagram?
Who is the true diva?
Where is the love and hip hop Atlanta?
And what happened in the King B elevators?
That's what's happening today and more on the Buzz. Sit back, pour a drink, and get your buzz on.
I'm Deshaun, and we have our host here today.
I'm Sarita Monet from Brooklyn.
I'm Travis Dimitri from the Bronx.
This is Deshaun.
I'm Joey from the city. Well, we got a little variety there, right?
Well, of course, you're from the city.
And the city, you know, we got
Brooklyn.
It all.
Okay, cool.
Push that on, queen,
no queen. We don't have no queen.
Ooh, that's a shot.
Oh, we do.
Why don't you start the first topic, man?
Okay,
go
okay,
on, get going.
First topic, all right. Ellen DeGeneres may have the most retweeted selfies of all time, but when it comes to the most likes on Instagram, Kim Kardashian is the queen. The new bride shared two pictures on her Instagram account, but the snapshot of her kissing her hubby, Kanye West, has earned almost 2 million likes, making it the most liked pictures on Instagram of all time. Let's talk about this. Why do we love Kim Kardashian so much?
We all know she's talentless, but
she's very talented in a talentless, though.
Right, but she's
the best of the talentless.
She just looks good. That's what she's like selling. Yeah. But what?
Yeah, she looks good to some people. Was, yeah. You think she looks good?
She's great. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
She's like, it's like a statue.
And then she has great fashion sense. She always looks good.
Well, I don't think that's really her, but.
No.
Of course not, but she has a great style.
She's faking it well.
There's only one Mariah, and she's not going anywhere. While she's inspired a whole new generation of divas, the iconic singer proves she hasn't lost her luster with the first album in nearly 5 years. It's called Me, I Am Mariah, the Elusive Chanteuse, in stores now. Entertainment Weekly says Ariana Grande may have been christened the new Mariah, but we still need the old one, and she's telling you that she's not going anywhere. So, fellow hosts, how do you feel about the comparison between Mariah Carey and Ariana Grande?
I just feel like she's very self-centered, everything's about Mimi.
Well, I mean, if you're gonna have a title called, an album called Me, I Am Mariah.
Every album after her, like, you don't know who she is.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's how I feel about it.
Yeah. And Ariana Grande? I mean, do you think one of them is better than the other one?
Ariana's pretty good.
I think anybody coming
into the game, you have to work their way up to legend before there's a comparison.
Yeah, at least four albums.
I feel like people need to cut her some slack. She is like 18 years old.
Yeah, right.
A billionaire already, so.
Come on up already.
Sad news to report, famed poet and author Maya Angelou has passed away at the age of 86. The author was recovering from an unnamed illness and died in North Carolina. The St. Louis native was Hollywood's first black female director, has over 30 honorary degrees, and has been nominated for a Pulitzer, a Tony, and an Emmy. On behalf of all of us here at The Buzz, New York City Live, our hearts go out to Maya's family and everyone who she inspired. Take a look.
Maya Angelou's legacy is twofold. She leaves behind a body of important artistic work that influenced several generations. But the 86-year-old was praised by those who knew her as a good person, a woman who pushed for justice and education and equality. Angelou was born April 4, 1928 in St. Louis. She grew up between St. Louis and the then racially segregated town of Stamps, Arkansas. The famous poet got into writing after a childhood tragedy that stunned her into silence for years. In an interview with CNN in January 2009, just days before President Obama was inaugurated for his first term, Angelou gave her thoughts about the United States election of its first black president.
Maya, Dr. Angelou, what do the words mean to you, President-elect Obama?
I'm overwhelmed. I'm thrilled in the classic sense of that word. My whole body is moved. I go like that. It's just amazing.
An icon, a trailblazer, and now forever immortalized, we salute Maya Angelou for using her life and her literacy to enlighten the masses. May she rest in peace.
three headed to the beach, South Beach.
Sun comes out tomorrow.
And then because I don't drink milk, got almond breeze.
Initially in my transition, I didn't think my family supported me.
Welcome back. We have our sexy correspondent with us, Mr. Bronson Johnson. How are you today?
I'm doing wonderful, Travis. How about yourself?
I'm doing well, living. You know how that works.
How was your week?
Very busy, keeping up with the buzz. But I talk about my week. I heard you have a new segment.
Yes, I do. I am handling the Make Me Over segment, which deals with fashion. And on this week of Make Me Over, celebrity makeup artist AJ Crimson made an exclusive appearance at the recently opened Kinnick and Alcone in the West Village. In our Make Me Over fashion, we provided three makeovers to three women who wanted to see how they could be fierce in two snaps. What's up, everybody? It's Bronson from The Buzz. We're here at Kinnick and Alcone, where celebrity makeup artist AJ Crimson is going to showcase his work. We also have three lovely ladies who are going to get a makeover so they can learn how to be fierce in two snaps.
Just to get an everyday look and just kind of almost be pampered by AJ Crimson.
Want to see more of his contouring. And basically, yeah, that's it. Everyday flawless makeup. Nothing too heavy, just can't wait to see the after. The before is okay.
Totally make me over, yeah.
Make me over.
Do a little bit of makeup. I follow my friends who are makeup artists and I kind of copy. But an everyday look is kind of hard to find. I'm looking forward to the makeover.
Tell me the look that you're looking for.
Just a clean look, like a nice, crisp, everyday look.
Okay, awesome. So what I'm going to try on you right now is the AJ Crimson BB Plus D.
Okay.
With the BB Plus D, you're going to get your moisturizer, your primer, you're going to get all the vitamins. It has almond oil, mango butter, AC.
And I won't have to, like, really put too much moisturizer?
No, this is your moisturizer. This takes the place of a moisturizer and a primer. You're good to go.
Okay.
Welcome back, everyone. What do you guys think about it?
Great.
It was good.
Awesome.
It was a makeover. You know, get the job, right? Get the job done.
Gorgeous.
Really?
Exactly. It did.
It really changed.
It had a purpose.
Different. They're like different people. Yeah. Completely and totally different people.
You can definitely see where
the direction of like where makeup is going.
Right.
The women look great. The different colors.
It was enhanced. It was good.
Good. And speaking of segments, we each have our own individual segments as hosts. And I have a wonderful game that we're going to play to introduce all of our hosts and who they are. Cool. So, on these index cards, I have some secrets from each individual host, and we're going to guess who is who. All right. Okay. You guys ready?
Yep. Ready, ready. Cool.
All right. So first
Sean.
One. First one. This person joined the Polar Bear Club. Can you guess?
Polar Bear.
What is
the
polar bear?
Hold up.
Yeah,
definitely Travis. I see that look on his face. He did it.
All right.
Ain't
wrong.
Oh, wait, I guess.
It's you.
What? You already said you did it.
All right.
So, will the person that joined the Polar Bear Club please stand up?
Boom! I was right. I told you.
You don't know what it is?
No, what is that? A sorority?
No, it's where you hop in the Atlantic in January.
Okay, cool. All right, that's cool. I couldn't do that.
That's too cold. All right, next one. This person wants to be famous.
That's Travis. I think it's Travis.
That's
you Travis. Guys,
that's
absolutely
Travis.
Right. That's Travis. Travis wants to be famous.
All right, next one. This person got locked in the elevator on the 4th of July. Penthouse party. Who was that?
Deshaun.
I think Sarita.
Sorry, guys. They all got it wrong.
It was me.
It's Travis.
It was Travis. What?
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
That's cool.
How long
were you trapped in the elevator for?
Too long. The fire department had it coming on.
Oh, for real?
Are you serious?
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
I can't.
Are you claustrophobic?
I had a peanut cup, too. That's
how I got it.
Oh, man.
All right, next one. This host loves watching crime shows.
Sarita.
You guys are all wrong.
What? Okay. It was you.
It was Sean. See, I saw Miami, New York, Forensic Files, all that. I'm all into that. I was just like, that's crazy.
All right, our next one. This host used to be an assistant to a former celebrity.
Travis.
Next.
Travis.
All right, this host attended 3 different high schools in...
Sarita, boom. We can't don't even finish.
That's right. Throw it out the window. This one is still scared of vampires.
Deshaun.
Nah. Joey.
That is correct. And this one has 2 younger sisters.
Sarita.
No, I think it's Deshaun this time.
Y'all all wrong because it's me.
That was good.
All right, guys, our game is over. Now that you got to know our hosts on a personal level, they're gonna explain to you their individual segments and what they're gonna be hosting this year on The Buzz.
Well, my segment of the show is gonna be the musical where we go throughout New York City and meet independent artists. We meet the bands, you know, the new hot artists coming up in New York City.
Lucky. You ready for that?
I'm a little envious.
I'm going to do What's New York? I'm going to take you all around to different locales, show you what really is New York City throughout the 5 boroughs, and it should be really cool. Different galleries, restaurants.
And you're from New York, right, Joey? So,
yeah,
like, you know New York like the back of your hand.
Right here. Right. I know it all.
Well, I'm Deshaun. I'll be doing the blind dating game where I will take 2 individuals on the train. And if they can last the whole train ride, female on the bus, New York City line. So it's going to be crazy. People going to be like getting wild and crazy people out. It's going to be crazy.
So I have to ask you, Deshaun, is it going to be random people?
Just random. It's blind dating. Random people. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You're going to see a midget with a NBA player? I don't know.
That sounds pretty dangerous. Anyway, on my segment, I'll be doing NYC Talks. So I will be in the streets and I'll be getting the feedback on what's hot, what's not from pedestrians and cool things like that, you know, just right in the heart of New York City.
Okay.
Times Square.
So like hot topics, Q&As.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool.
Well, I'm super excited for all our shows. Yes!
Line date on me?
The Buzz Spotlight is next.
Tonight is the night.
Welcome back. Now we're gonna do the Buzz Spotlight. And the category is?
Fake or phony. Speaking of phony, did you guys see Love & Hip Hop with Mimi?
All you gotta say is Love & Hip Hop.
It's getting too scripted.
Yeah, it's very gimmicky, if that's even a word. Just, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So they did the porn tape though, right? I mean,
film tape and nothing like adult.
Was that shown on the?
What's weird to me? How do you go from?
It's a part of the storyline.
But how do you go from maid to porn star? Like,
it's a low blow.
That's like crazy to me. That's like,
my whole thing is don't act surprised. You understand what I'm saying? When he's telling you it leaks, you knew it was gonna leak.
If it was him. He's the only one that had it.
She wanted that kid.
My bags were missing. My bags.
So was it a good porn? I didn't get to watch it yet.
And the category is?
Music Spotlight. All right, so let's talk about real quick Danny DeCane. So they're back on tour. Ooh. Don't do that.
Okay.
They're back on tour, they started with four.
They have five. Right, okay.
Back on tour, four, and now currently three.
Wow.
So we went to Danny DeCane to Destiny Show? Is that what you're saying?
As we know that girl groups don't really last anymore, so it's like, they're good. Right. But
how long were they together for now?
They just got back after P. Diddy fired them. But we'll see what happens.
Yeah, these girl groups.
Right.
Yeah.
But anyway, the category is?
Diva Moment. So, what do we think happened up there with the elevator and Beyonce and Solange? I mean,
I wouldn't call that a diva moment.
That's not a diva moment.
That might be an Illuminati moment.
Not Illuminati.
Right, seriously, it was too good to be true that their marriage was so perfect and was trying to, because she's ratchet from Houston.
But their marriage is still good.
No, it's good, but. They just got exposed, you know?
But who got exposed? It wasn't like it was Jay and Beyonce.
Yeah,
it was Solange.
They
were the same elevator.
There's always a crazy.
She probably just hate her brother-in-law. It could be that.
Like I said, they got exposed.
I think he said something disrespectful in Solange.
To Solange or to Beyonce?
The way she was beating him up, it doesn't look like it was the first time.
He probably just told her, when your album coming out, and she just lost it.
I heard she got cut from Rock Nation.
He probably like, when your album coming out, she's like, what? What? And then this other
right. Whatever, he's still ratchet.
And the category is?
Upgrade. All right, guys. Dr. Dre just sold Beats to Apple for $3 billion. Not million, but $1 billion. How do y'all feel about that? That's crazy,
He's a billionaire now. That's good for him. But me personally, I wouldn't have sold.
Supposedly.
Crazy? $3 billion?
Yeah.
I was
supposedly that he's like, well, he calls himself like hip hop's first billionaire.
Right.
I mean, I don't know how accurate.
But
that
he's definitely
is,
not Doctor's first billionaire.
He has no damn doctorate.
But $3 billion? You wouldn't sell for $3 billion?
No, he's paid.
You wouldn't sell for $3 billion, Serena? Really?
I think it's an opportunity to make more money.
He could have capitalized.
Who
are you talking about? Who you talking about? I got $3 billion. You just talk about let's go to Applebee's and you ain't giving up.
I would have sold.
Who's that Applebee's?
Oh, that's cool.
Thank you for watching the Buzz NYC
Live.
Be sure to watch us locally here in New York and make sure you visit whatsthebuzztv.com for the latest of our cast. Yes.
That's us.
Entertainment, news, and much, much more.
I just want to thank our lovely producer of the Buzz NYC Live, Nunu. Thank you so much.
Nunu.
Love you. And this is the Buzz.
Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with Nunu, just visit yourboynunu.com.